Hey everybody, welcome back. I'm Kevin P Nichols and you're watching my video series on kevinpnichols.com where we discuss all things content. Last week we discussed the notion of performance-driven content. This week we're on to another exciting topic called intelligent content. Intelligent content is not content that is intelligent, where it has an intelligence quotient the size of Albert Einstein. It's content that has logic built into it in order to meet certain goals and objectives for an organization or for an end user. Anne Rockley and Charles Cooper, in their book Managing Enterprise Content, define quite well what intelligent content is, how to use it, and how to structure your content so it can be supported through an intelligent content model. We're not going to talk about that today so much, but we're going to give you an overview on why it's important and some considerations that you should be thinking about when looking at intelligent content decisions. Now, for intelligent content to function well and be done right in an organization, you have to look at both the internal mechanisms to support it, that is the internal mechanisms to publish intelligent content, and the external areas in which you want to build logic into your content so that it is in fact intelligent. Examples of intelligent content for the external audience include anything that's personalized, so personalization. And when I talk about personalization, I'm specifically talking about content that is targeted to a consumer based on who they are, what they may or may not be doing, so what their need is within the context of a customer journey, what device they may be consuming that content on, when they're doing it. So for an example, if they're doing it around a birthday or a particular event, you may be able to find ways to personalize an experience around that. And also why. What are their unique drivers that are engaging them in order to want to consume that content in the first place? So intelligent content includes personalization. It also includes any type of logic that you build in to support multi-channel or dynamic publishing. So for an example, I am a consumer and I'm looking at content on my mobile device versus a desktop website versus an in-store kiosk or digital signage even. So multi-channel content is content that gets published out to different channels or different platforms for the end user. Intelligent content also looks at things such as recommendations logic. Recommendations logic is what you might see on a site like Amazon.com, where if you have created a user profile with them and purchased a product previously with them, they might serve up content that they feel is specific to a need or driver that you have. So as you can see in my example that I'm showing here on my Amazon.com site, you can see that they've specifically targeted content to me based on my previous purchasing decisions and behaviors. You can also see that there's a lot of what we call cross-sell or upsell going on. Cross-sell or upsell is when you take a product that you've purchased previously and you make recommendations on other types of products that may support that particular product. Intelligent content is very important for this day and age for businesses to get content out to their consumers that meets their consumer needs. It can really help keep an organization relevant and timely insofar as its product or services are concerned. So we talked a little bit about what intelligent content means for an external consumer. Let's discuss how you do it and what mechanisms are in place in order, or that you need in place in order to effectively support it. Remember last time when we discussed performance-driven content? That's content where you, once you publish it, you measure its efficacy and how well it's performing to determine where to take it in the future. Well, any type of intelligent content decisions should be based upon user behavior and what user needs are and how they're responding to your content. So whether you're talking about personalization or content that you recommend based on previous purchase decisions or previous behaviors of the end user, you want to make sure that you're looking at what it is that they've shown an interest in, how they interact with your content, how well your content performs vis-a-vis their needs, to make future decisions around what areas you can further personalize or recommendations logic that you build up. So first and foremost, if you're going to be doing intelligent content, you need to have that performance-driven model, that closed-loop process to support it. You also need to, and Anne Rockley talks about this in her book, structure the content so that it can adaptively respond to different devices and different scenarios in which it's used. An example of this is when you're designing a template for a content management system. You may want, and let's just take the example of a product. You may want to create a template that is in one place where you have a product description long that might go out to a desktop website, a medium product description that might go out to product packaging, and a short product description that would go out to the mobile device, all captured in one area. Structuring your content in this particular format allows you to structure it in a very nimble and adaptive fashion. So you can respond to changing trends in the industry. You can also respond to any inputs that you get insofar as your users are using it or how well it's performing. And you can also make sure that you're able to manage and maintain it in an effective and in a well-sustained environment. Businesses that do intelligent content and do it right put forth content that is relevant, that is timely, that is meaningful, and that is useful to their end users. They also put themselves in a position where they can competitively respond to changes in the marketplace, as well as put themselves in a position where they can publish content in an effective, nimble, and adaptive fashion. So hopefully that gives you an idea about what intelligent content is, where you can use it in order to think about your future content solutions, and provides a bit of an overview in terms of why you would want to utilize intelligent content in your future content decisions. You can find more information on how to effectively utilize and execute intelligent content solutions in my new book, Enterprise Content Strategy, which is also forwarded by Anne Rockley. Next time, we will be discussing omnichannel. Thanks for listening, and I look forward to seeing you again.